Rudy's party.
There were roses growing in a patch by the screen door. On the pink steps, spotted spearmint fixed our stomachs when too much cake and jello kept us up at night. Little Rudy's party went on and on and on. Even after Rudy fell asleep, tired from running circles in the brown grass, too excited about anything, not knowing or caring about turning 5. I guess everything looks so big when you're that small. Huge shoes coming through the house singing, "Déjame morir." Uncle Pancho whistled and Tio Benny wore that dumb-looking straw hat and always put on cowboy boots when he got drunk. Stunk bad in our faces saying, "Ay, qué chulo." Oh yeah, and Manuel could fly. Well, he said he could. Only when the moon was full, or more like when his belly was full of cough medicine and beer. The hot dogs and bread tasted good, but the beans had fat chunks of onion that made me sneeze. My grandmother liked them that way, with a big orange soda on the side, so I made her a plate to take to her because she can't come out no more. Some of the presents were wrapped in the Sunday funny papers, some wrapped in the white butcher stuff you get at Carvajal's Dandy Market. But Rudy won't be opening them today. He's too little and sleepy. I bet he'll be up real early tomorrow before the pots line up at the corner for soup and eyes are too red to get out of bed. Everybody got silly and somebody got very stupid that long day. But the sky forgave and the clouds moved away, making it all right. "Happy birthday to you," the rooster cried. "Happy birthday for you," the bird sang up in the palm trees. "And have a nice life," all the neighbors shouted. And for miles around, car horns honked and lunch wagons tooted their goofy songs. Even the church bells rang 5 times for Rudy, and 1 more time for good luck.